Hello everybody, it is me, Poppy Sklander 2, and this time it will be my Halloween video. Okay, it's more a bit sad than scary, but considering I haven't done a total drama video in ages, so I thought maybe I could do my first Halloween video with this theory right here. Why is Duncan in juvee? So, we have quite a lot of evidence for this, and I'll explain why. So, in the first episode of the first season, Duncan even gets his own intro music, because he's all so-called rough and tough and stuff like that. But when you go on to the later seasons, he kind of gets a bit bullied a bit by people like Alejandro, Courtney and Gwen. And it kind of actually makes sense for after all what he's been through about the whole love triangle and stuff like that. It's because people see him as the main victim. So that's the one reason why. Because it maybe made him mad and maybe he wanted revenge for what those people did. So that's the second reason. Basically, he has told some of the others, including Gwen, Heather and Owen, that how he got into juvee, and they were all surprised. So in episode 23 of the first season, Owen says, before you die, why don't we all get our confessions out? So they did, but we only got the ending part of what Duncan, Heather and Gwen were talking about. So Gwen just replies with wow, and I forgot the line, but it's because I haven't watched episode 23 in ages. But it's kind of sad when you think about it. He probably from this he was maybe bullied when he was a young child, and maybe got into juvee because he had enough and wanted revenge, but his revenge was too violent for just like beat up, get told off and that's it. Maybe it was even more violent, like maybe even a knife, to be honest, considering Duncan always holds a knife, so that could be the knife that he attacked someone with. It's pretty scary if you actually think about it, the young child Duncan actually being bullied into doing it. Well, not particularly bullied into doing it, his mind was set to do it, and that means there's only a few people left that actually likes him. His sister, because Duncan actually does have a sister in season 2 in one of the final episodes. Basically, he says sis and I wear dwinky vests and sell apples, and talks about why they're such Houdinis at tying knots. So we know that he has a very caring sister and that she doesn't bully him because, well, why would they then have fun and sell apples together and tie and untie knots together like they're actually having fun? And then there's his mum. So why I'm not putting his dad here as well, it's because his dad treats Duncan like a toy. Like, seriously, if you see the response for the home message. Basically, Duncan's dad says something really horrible about about Duncan and his, because his officer is coming around, and that the many times what things he did, and we can use these things he did to actually know why. So he had a massive party, had this at the fountain, and he also had another massive party to celebrate New Year, which totally failed, and then selling his dad's hairpiece for a pair. So these things aren't really violent, but that's probably because he was only playing pranks. So, but it was his dad, it was only family, it wasn't like other people, like at his kind of like probably preschool or school or even senior school, something like that. So that's what I believe. I believe that he went to get his revenge on the people who despised him and looked at him first sight and thought to bully him. And it wasn't right. And when you think about it, that's how he became himself. So that's why I believe Duncan is now in juvee, because he wanted revenge, but his way of revenge wasn't normal kind of revenge of like the normal beat them up, getting into trouble and that's it. It was another form of trouble, and that trouble was with his knife that he holds today. I really hope you enjoyed this video. So that's the end of my theory, and I make a video if you want to build onto this theory if you want. So I hope you enjoyed, and good day and goodbye.